In this video, we're going to explore another type of inhibition, and this is uncompetitive inhibition. Similar to what we talked about with competitive inhibition, a molecule that is an uncompetitive inhibitor will prevent an enzyme from working properly. But the big difference is that an uncompetitive inhibitor binds to a different part of the enzyme, right? So the idea here is that this is our enzyme, and as we talked about before, the substrate binds to the active site. So this is our substrate. For a competitive inhibitor, we talked about how it would bind to the same spot of the enzyme. But in uncompetitive inhibition, this inhibitor actually binds to a different spot in the enzyme. So this here is our inhibitor. And when this uncompetitive inhibitor binds, it prevents the substrate from being converted to product. So we cannot get conversion to product. If we think about this in terms of our kinetic mechanism, so this is the same one we've seen many times before now. In this case, our uncompetitive inhibitor binds to the enzyme substrate complex to form an enzyme substrate inhibitor complex. Okay, so we have an inhibitor that binds to the enzyme substrate complex and prevents conversion of the substrate to a product. For uncompetitive inhibition, we want to do the same thing that we did for competitive inhibitors. We want to figure out how Km is influenced and how Vmax is influenced. Okay, and we're going to take the same approach as we did for a competitive inhibitor. We're going to think about this in the context of Le Chatelier's principle. Okay, so remember that for Km, we are focusing in on this equilibrium. We're thinking about how this equilibrium itself will be influenced by adding an inhibitor. And in this case, adding an inhibitor will actually draw the equilibrium towards the enzyme substrate complex, and then it'll be pulled towards this enzyme substrate inhibitor complex. So the presence of an inhibitor pulls the Km equilibrium towards the enzyme substrate complex. So if there's an inhibitor around, it will look like this equilibrium favors products more than if there's not an inhibitor around. Okay, so let's say that one more time. In the presence of an uncompetitive inhibitor, the Km equilibrium is drawn more towards the enzyme substrate complex than without an inhibitor around. That means we observe a higher affinity, meaning that in the presence of an inhibitor, our Km value actually decreases because we have a higher affinity. So we have a lower Km if there's an inhibitor around. How about Vmax? Well, with Vmax, we're thinking about the conversion of our enzyme substrate complex to enzyme plus products, right? So we're thinking about this rate constant here, K2. And we know that we can only achieve Vmax if 100% of our enzyme is in the form of the enzyme substrate complex, right? So if all of the enzyme is in this form. However, in the case of an uncompetitive inhibitor, no matter how much substrate we add, right? So no matter how much of our substrate here we add, we can never, ever, ever get rid of the presence of our enzyme substrate inhibitor complex. So this complex will always exist. So it will never be true that 100% of the enzyme is in the form of the enzyme substrate complex, because some of it will always be in this inhibited complex. Consequently, we can never reach the same maximal velocity. So in an inhibited reaction, we also see a lower Vmax. So this is with the inhibitor. Okay, so uncompetitive inhibitors are fairly easy to remember. Both Km and Vmax decrease. Km decreases because we see an apparent higher affinity because this equilibrium is shifted more towards the enzyme substrate complex because some of it gets pulled towards this inhibited complex. Vmax decreases because we can never get 100% of our enzyme in the form of our enzyme substrate complex. So in the next video, we'll go ahead and look at how these changes influence the profile of our Michaelis-Menten graph, which remember we plot as V0 versus the concentration of substrate. And we'll look and see how it influences our Lineweaver-Burk plot, which is 1 over V0 versus 1 over the substrate concentration.